you want to stretch.
Okay. So, we're going to stretch our legs?
You can do any kind of stretch you want.
So, touch your toes.
Just make sure you still stretch your legs and arms a little bit.
Yeah, a little bit. So, we're just stretching our arms and our legs. Okay. So.
And then when you're done with that.
When you're done with that.
You want to get
well, we're just trying to hurry. So.
You can stretch as long as you want. Yeah. Just make sure you don't sprain or hurt anything.
Yeah.
So you want to kind of sit on the edge of the ball. You want to kind of lay down. Fall back. And make sure you push with your arms to come forward. Fall back. Push with your arms to come forward. Make sure you keep doing that until you get used to going back. And then.
Can we just dodge it?
Going back and pushing.
Okay.
And keep doing that. And Bradley, you try.
Oh, and if I forgot to mention, this is our friend Bradley.
Okay, go.
Oh, I didn't hear.
And you also might need a little bit of supervision if you don't feel good with doing this by yourself.
Yeah.
Feel good. And
that
make sure.
Sticky, that one's sticky. Hey, guys.
And then make sure when you go back, you want to push all the way forward. You go back, push the way forward.
If you do it halfway,
because you'll hit it on.
When you actually do one, you'll hit it on here.
Because if you do it just halfway, you just go like this, and you go like this, and you go like, and eventually you'll fall forward.
Yeah, like this. Now what would happen if you were, so this is what you guys are going to do. This is what you guys are going to do, okay? And yeah, if you don't have like a, exercise ball, you could
use any kind of big ball that you can lay on.
Yeah. So after you do that, Bradley,
you want to, get on the ground. Hold your knees, go back,
and start rolling.
And push forward.
And start rolling.
Sometimes, but when you go back, you don't want to hold your knees. So you can kind of start like this, and then go back. And then
oh, push. And guys, I'll do a demonstration. Push. I'll do a demonstration of a front handspring.
Go back, push.
Hey guys, let me do a demonstration. Push. So Bradley's gonna do a demonstration push. Of a front handspring.
It's kind of like a back handspring, but you're just doing it forwards.
So that's one, okay? I'll do what I can do for my back.
And
I used to be able to do it.
Whenever you do a back handspring, you want to make sure you push off.
In a front handspring, same as a back handspring, but you're actually going back, not frontwards.
Yeah, so you want to make sure you push off with your arms so that you can
push.
Because if you just keep it like this, you're eventually just going to fall on your back or your head.
Yeah, so you got to go like,
you got to push. And I'll show you an example. Guys.
Yeah. Yeah, he's gonna show an example.
Of a good and a bad. First, here's the good.
Yeah.
And then here's the bad.
Yeah. That's bad.
I kind of hurt my arm on that, but that happens.
That's bad.
That's what you don't want to do.
That's, but you'll learn.
And Bradley, he's working on back foot, so Bradley, you show
them that. Okay, I just want to show you guys, so. So let's keep doing this, right, Bradley?
Yeah, you want to get back and then push.
Get back, push.
And if you really want
to. Push.
Yeah.
And if you really want to, you can roll all the way back and then push and get up. You can, what they're doing, pull back, push, get up. And then if you can't do that, you keep trying. This.
And then eventually,
guys, if you have so much power, you could like go up like that.
But if you still can't do that, you can go like this. But make sure you don't go off your head. Make sure you go off your shoulder so you don't hurt your neck.
Yeah. But
so you get used to rolling backwards.
Or like this.
Uh-huh.
So now what do we do? Hey guys, we're on a mat, so it's softer than real ground.
Yeah, so. I'm going to use Bradley here.
But you guys don't have to be on
your mat. You're going to bend back, put your arms out, bend back, put your arms out, hold it, for 10 seconds. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And with someone's help, they're going to help you swing the leg
back,
over.
Flip back, Okay, but you'll need a helper for this. And guys, if you don't have any help, you can just go like this.
bench, and when you do get home, they can hold your legs and swing you back.
Yeah, yeah. So, I'll go back. Oh, gosh.
You can lay down.
Watch this, guys.
Sometimes you lay back first, and then you get the legs, and flip.
Then you flip. But you want to land on your feet.
And you don't want to hold them by their, like, thighs up here. You kind of want to get down here. Because if you hold them by the thighs, their head will get stuck through your legs.
And that would be just a weird situation.
Okay, So now what do we do?
You kind of want to learn how to put your hands out and go down like this. Just keep doing that. Keep trying. Just get down. If you need help,
yeah, I can help.
You put your, they'll hold you up like this, hold the chest, and then put their arms down, and then hold that. And then eventually they'll get up.
Yeah, and then get up.
And so then keep doing it, but we won't help them as much. Go down, hands up. And then they'll keep doing that until they can actually do that.
Yeah.
So pretend Cooper did it without any help. Go down. And then you can tell him, hold it. Hold it.
Okay.
And then you grab
Hold on.
You grab their legs. And you swing them
back.
So you can get used to going back and then swinging over.
Yeah. This is, like, my first time trying this, so this is me, okay? This is what, you guys might do the same, but.
You can't really do it, which is why you gotta practice swinging.
Or, guys, if your dad or something can't help you or your mom,
you could just lay down. Try it again, but go back and keep your arms up. starts to go backwards, you want to get high and then go backwards.
So
Bradley, try one more time. This time, get high and flip.
Okay.
Yeah, but that's good because that's a good practice. But don't go sideways. Put your arms straight right here.
Guys,
your head in the middle.
Like this.
Yeah, but you don't want to go sideways still.
Yeah, I'm.
When you jump, put your arms like right here. Swing, put your head right here. Like if I went down, my thumbs would touch my ears. So I went up, and then I went up, I flip back, and then my hands hit the ground, and then I flip over with my legs. Make sure you get that momentum in your legs, too. No one forget about that.
Yeah, so I'm gonna try it.
There you go. But still, you went to the side.
Yeah,
what? If you go to the side, that's where your momentum goes.
Yeah, but Bradley, can you do it again?
Yeah.
He's gonna do it.
Alright. So you wanna keep your arms straight and go up like straight. Like if you look down when you land and your feet are about to come down, your hands want to be able to slide and touch your feet. You don't want them to be like this, so you
can't go off. You guys could work on. I just made this up, but you could go like this and practice pushing off your knee.
Yeah, like watch.
So you could do a headstand and then go like, and start to flip off.
But yeah. Sometimes it might not be good if you can't really do a handstand at all.
Yeah.
So
you could do it off the wall.
Like this.
Or you could go
like this.
This and then work pushing your hands off. Off the ground so you don't like hit your head from the push.
Or this.
Yeah.
So like this.
Mm-hmm.
To like push off.
So Bradley, try it one more. Cooper, try it one more time, but hands up straight.
Yeah, guys, you're not gonna get it in one day, so don't be bummed that you can't do it straight away.
Some of you might be able to because you're really close, but. You still probably won't be able to.
Yeah.
Might take a couple hours, minutes, depends.
No, or even a day. Or yeah. Even a week.
Depends.
Yeah, how
so,
much time?
Okay, Cooper, do it. Try one more time. Hands straight up and then go.
Hey guys,
there you go.
You're still
twisting your
it's
body.
It's kind of weird.
Keep your body straight the whole way. Unless you want
to bend. A backflip on a trampoline before I learned a.
Yeah.
Before you do any of this, like try on a back handspring on a trampoline.
Yeah, but you still do the.
And it's kind of funny, guys. And it's kind of funny because I actually learned a backflip on a trampoline before I learned
back handspring.
Because sometimes
I just like literally learned it in 5 minutes.
Sometimes your arms aren't as powerful.
Air mass is way better.
Sometimes your arms aren't as powerful as your legs, so you can do backflip, but you can't do back handspring. But eventually, that'll develop.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So that's gonna be the end.
You guys can practice this at Sky Zone
or
on a trampoline.